important. نكمل ولا ايش؟ مش عارف. Thank you.
Shukran. Thank you, Abed.
Afwan.
Great music, and it's all pleasure to be to hear the calling for love and the night of our hearts. First of all, I would like to invite Shahabudi to give his short comment. And later, after that, I'll speak to introduce Rabbi Hadass and Zizi, and we'll pass everything to the voice of the women today. Shahabudin, please.
Well, I don't have the voice of a woman, but I certainly have the awareness that at this time, we all really need to be connected. Women, men, children, older people, all colors, all religions, and we all need to connect with God. That's the way. So I appreciate this meeting so much because it's a living sign of us being connected. So thank you for letting me speak. I'm finished.
Thank you. Thank you, Shahab, for coming today to be with us. The discussion and the prayer. I would like to say that she is fluent in Hebrew, Arabic, English. She grew with this, and she doing lots of connection and connecting work in the Holy Land, in Israel, between the Israeli and the Palestinians. Arabai, Dalia, it's yours, and after that, thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Sheikh Manasra. Salam, shalom, peace. I'm really grateful to be participating in this sacred and hopeful moment. I would like to share a few thoughts and words about compassion and then share a prayer. The gate of compassion, Baba Rahma, Sha'al Khamim, stands directly to the east of the Dome of the Rock, the heart of prayers and worship. It has been blocked, the gate, for more than 200 years for fear of spiritual rising. Compassion comes from the same root, Rahamim, Rahma, Raham. It is only after we left that womb that we were given a name, a language, a culture, a religion. According to Jewish tradition, redemption will enter the Holy of Holies through the gate of compassion, that gate of wombs, maybe through this recognition of humanity's oneness. And there is another language that also unites us that existed here in this region that has been troubled for so long, but has also known times of peace, and that is the language of Aramaic, which is a sister language to both Hebrew and Arabic. And in Aramaic, one of the names, the divine, is Rahamana, which literally translates as our womb or our compassion, the compassionate, the merciful. So I would like to share a short prayer in Aramaic that the words mean compassionate one who responds to the poor. Please answer our praise. Compassionate one who responds to the brokenhearted. Please answer our prayers. Rahamana de ane ilani e o anena. Rahamana de ane ilani e o anena. Rahamana de'anei litvirei liba, o anena, o anena. May the force of compassion accompany us in this prayer. And I'm delighted and honored to invite Zeynab, who is the Abrahamic Reunion International Youth Leader from Nazareth, Israel. And from what I read in her biography that is on the website, has also been a peace activist pretty much from birth and has acted in so many ways and with so many people to bring peace to this land. So Zeynab, please. Thank you for joining us and hosting.
So thank you very much, really from all of my heart, and I miss you, all of you. So I will start now. Assalamu alaikum, shalom aleichem, peace to all of you. I'm so happy to be with you and to be together this evening. it's my pleasure to pray with you for all the world to be one heart at this meeting. This is a very important meeting for the Abrahamic Reunion and for all of the women and for all of the world. Because we will hold the energy and the power for the women and will pray together from our pure heart to all of the world to come to pray with us. We need to heal all of the world, to change all of the world, to love one another, to connect one another, and to know one another. And this is our time. This is the holy time. Thank you. And now I will introduce the Rabbanit Solary Rosen to give her prayer. But before that, I will read her short bio. Rabbanit Solary Rosen runs an online Jewish law response for women answering questions in all fields of Jewish law halakha. She is a graduate of the Department of Talmud and English Literature and lectures in various institutions of advanced studies of Judaism. Solary lives in Jerusalem and is a mother of 6 children. Yes, please.
Hi, everyone. What I was actually wanted to be talking about today is, I don't want to spoil the very festive atmosphere that we have, festive as well as responding to one another. But when Sheikh Manasra asked me to speak today, I was thinking about the difficulty of praying sometimes. And as a mother, I find that I have difficulty finding the time to stand in prayer, to concentrate in prayer at given times of the day, or using certain words for prayer. And when I go back to our holiest book of Torah, and I'm looking for a figure, a female figure, who couldn't find the words to pray, I find the beautiful and very painful story of Hagar, mother of Ishmael. And we find 2 instances in the Torah where Hagar doesn't pray. She doesn't turn her eyes and heart to the heavens and prays. Rather, she suffers a lot and she's trying to escape a certain fate. And when God sees that Hagar is not praying, he is turning to her. He sends her a messenger. And I am in a way responding to what Sheikh Manasra wrote, that many people have given up hope of ever experiencing peace in the Middle East and in Israel. And even though it may lead to, you know, negative thinking or bad vibes, I think that sometimes giving up out of pain, out of not finding words to deal with certain situations, is the greatest call we can offer God. And this is when God understands and turns to us. And what I think Hagar shares with the actual history of the Jewish people, even though she herself wasn't considered Jewish, is that when the Egyptians were enslaving the people of Israel, the people of Israel stopped to pray. And instead of that, they were crying or calling out. They couldn't use actual words for prayer. They were using their tears, they were using their pain, they were basically giving up on the situation of ever being redeemed out of Egypt. And this is when God turns to Moses and tells him, I have heard their, not their prayers, I have heard their pain and I've heard their crying. So, you know, sometimes when we feel that that's it, we have reached rock bottom, this is when we can hope for God, the heavens turning to us and reaching out a hand in all kinds of painful situations where we don't find the strength and we don't find the words to pray. That doesn't mean that what we are experiencing is not heeded. So whoever is in pain, and the world now is in great pain and great confusion, and some people are giving up, whether psychologically or spiritually, it's not necessarily a bad sign. I don't mean giving up and turning to violence. That's not what I'm saying. But giving up does not mean that your call goes unheeded. So with these words, I hope, of comfort, I don't have anyone to introduce, but I want to thank you all for listening to me and for giving me the chance to listen to how you see prayer, how you see what it is that the world needs at this time and in general. So thank you from Jerusalem.
Thank you, Rabbanit Surale. Thank you for these encouraging words. I would like to introduce now Doris Hani Thiab. Doris leads a women's Bible study groups and organizes connections between churches in the Holy Land with churches in the United States and in Europe, and helps bring groups to Palestine in support of the Palestinian nation in order to create friendships among the people. So, Doris, please give us your words and thoughts.
Okay. شرفني اليوم أكون معكم في هذا اللقاء لحتى نبني جسور محبة وصداقة. أنا بحب أعرف على حالي، يعني أنا بحب هاي اللقاءات كثير. أول مرة بكون معكم. أنا نشطة في العمل والنشاط لأجل ما أؤمن به. عندنا نشاط، عندنا إحنا كنيسة عدد الرعية تقريباً 100 شخص. فعنا لقاءات شبيبة، عنا اجتماع سيدات لمرة في الأسبوع، مرة في الأسبوع دراسة الكتاب المقدس.
ممكن
نجتمع من مختلف.
ممكن ترجمي؟ ترجمي بس ترجمي عشان نترجم إذا ممكن. أنت بتحكي وإذا ممكن بس أبونا في راسي ترجم، بلاش يبين بس
ماشي إن شاء الله.
أوكي. جملة.
أول إشي بعرف عن حالي، أنا اسمي دورس دياب من الزبابدي، أم لأربعة أولاد.
My name is Doris. I'm from Zababdi. I am mother for four kids.
بشرفني إني أكون معكم في هذا اللقاء، أول مرة أنا بكون معكم.
It's an honor and a privilege to be with you, and it's an honor to meet you today.
فنايل جسور المحبة والصداقة.
Why we are meeting today? We are meeting today to building bridges for peace and for reconciliation, for friendship.
أنا نشطة في العمل ونشاط لأجل ما أؤمن به.
I'm very active in Zababdi because I believe what I'm doing in interfaith dialogue and in building bridges of friendships.
عنا نشاط سيدات في الرعية.
In Zababdi we have many activities. We have women activities. The women in Zabab, they are very active. We have a Bible group, ladies Bible group studies.
نعمل مرة في الأسبوع نجتمع كسيدات لدراسة الكتاب المقدس.
Okay, we met once a week, 30 ladies from different churches and from different backgrounds and different even faiths. We met in the church once a week to study the Bible and what we can do to make our relationship strong and to build the friendship with each other.
حتى نتعلم ما يقول الكتاب المقدس عن الإيمان والرجاء والمحبة والعمل المشترك.
We are learning and we are studying what the Bible says about faith and love each other. And we are not just studying, but we are acting to building relationships and friendships with each other.
حتى يربطنا نرتبط كسيدات صداقات وانتماء كل سيدة احنا كل سيدة بتنتمي لطائفة معينة.
Even our different faith and believe that every lady belongs to a different church or different background, we have one faith of humanity. We have one faith in a human being as created by God.
نجحنا أيضا في جلب حجاج عندنا هنا على الأراضي المقدسة مرتين في السنة عم بزوروا الكنيسة بزوروا كل الأماكن المقدسة في فلسطين وإن شاء الله هذا يعني رغم السنة الظروف كان عندنا حجاج في شهر 5 كانوا راح يزوروا الكنيسة فكان عندهم صعوبات واجهوها إنه صار هذا الفيروس وإن شاء الله إنه بنتهي على خير.
In Zimbabwe we have a program I love to name pilgrims to Zimbabwe. Pilgrims to Zimbabwe. We have groups from Europe, from Sweden, from Norway, from United States, and from Israel. The groups are not just Christians, but among the group they are Muslims and Jews. They come to visit us to learn about Palestine and the Palestinians and how we can build bridges, not walls, bridges of friendship and solidarity between Palestinians and the Israelis and the American and everyone.
نجحنا كمان في عمل صدقات من مختلف الديانات والطوائف.
So we have very successful to have friendships around the world. Among these friendships, we have Muslims and Christians and Jewish and from different denomination. We are Catholic, but we welcome groups from different denominations and from different faith and belief. So thanks God that we discovered that we are not just a Christian, but we love the Muslims and we love the Jewish. And we are working to discover each other and love each other.
Shukran, shukran ilkom. Thank you.
I hope my translation is understood.
Was great.
My English is not perfect, but I hope I succeeded to translate understood English by you.
Thank you
very much. Thank you for bringing this spirit.
Thank you.
I'm honored to introduce now Hanan Shahan, who is from Rafidiya in Nablus, She graduated from Rauda College and has helped with and attended many activities of the Abrahamic Reunion in Palestine. So Hanan, thank you for joining us, and we would love to hear your prayer.
أنا حنان شعبان. مش شعبان. أنا حنان شعبان من نابلس. تحديد أنا حنان شعبان من نابلس. تحياتي لكم جميعا. بشرفني معرفتكم. أنا منسقة عن منطقة نابلس. انضميت للجمعية من حوالي سنتين بدعوة إلي من محمد جاموس. أنا الجمعية كتير انبسطت فيها وانبسطت في أفكارها وأهدافها لأنها جمعية بتقوم على المحبة.
Dan, could you hold on one second so we can translate?
أنا حنان شعبان from Rafidia from Nablus, the area there, and I'm the person I connect with other people. I'm in connection with other people at that area. Mohammed Janous, the Palestinian director, he called. We began to work together. I'm so happy to be part of this organization. I found the essence and the work and the action of this organization is very, very, very good for me.
أنا هاي اللقاءات كتير استفدت منها. وغيري حتى استفاد منها يعني أهل نابلس كتير كانوا ينضموا للقاءات اللي كنا نروح عليها والكل كان كتير ينبسط اللقاءات كانت يعني كتير حلوة والجميع كان يعني يفضل إنه دائما باستمرار إنها اللقاءات تكون موجودة.
I learned a lot from this meeting of Abrahamic Reunion. And the Israelis also, but especially in Nablus, many people came when I invited them to come to be part of our organization and to come to our meeting events. They learned a lot and they are so happy and they full of hope for connecting and the other people in the future.
كانت موجودة من يعني من سنتين كانت يعني هاي اللقاءات جعلت العلاقات بيناتنا وبين جميع الديانات علاقة قوية ومتينة.
هاي اللقاءات this meeting it began 2 years ago and before long ago but 2 years ago I began to be very active at this organization and really this events and these meetings changed a lot in our areas, in our city and all around. تفضلي حنان.
وهي اللقاءات والبرامج برضو عملت يعني قوت العلاقات وجعلتها متينة وإن شاء الله جميعا إن شاء الله إحنا وجميع الديانات نستمر في هذا النهج من أجل السلام والمحبة ونتطبق هذه اللقاءات على أرض الواقع وتتحسن الأوضاع إن شاء الله في كل العالم.
This meetings create a very deep connection between us as a human being. It creates connection, and we know the other. Not only we heard from our prejudice or from the news, but we met and we touch and we feel that the people gather, and it creates a very good connection between us and between the other. And we pray from now for God to give us more connection and more meetings and together for to repair all of that bad situation and to create a good situation between all of us.
وهذه اللقاءات برضو عملت على تعزيز الثقة والتعاون على الجانب الفلسطيني الخط الفلسطيني.
And these meetings also create a very good connection between the Palestinians themselves.
إن شاء الله إن شاء الله وأنا بتمنى أن الأوضاع تتحسن وتصير عندنا لقاءات على أرض الواقع يعني إن شاء الله ونجتمع قريبا وألف شكر للجميع.
I pray for God to send us peace and send us love to create a good meetings face to face, to meet together in Israel and Palestine, and to create a good future for all of our children. Thank you, she said. Thank you.
Shukran.
Thank you very much. And now we will hear the prayer of Siham Halabi. But first, I will read her short bio. Siham Halabi is a Jews leader and the director of women's programs and adult education at the Dalia Carmel Community Center, providing courses women economic empowerment, home drivers, social activism, and interfaith understanding. She is coordinator of the trust when a member of the women's parliament and various organizations for dialogue and understanding between the culture and for the development of women and social issues affecting women. She is a Druze spokeswoman representing Druze women and national forums. Siham?
طبعا انا بدي ابدا تحياتي لكل الجمهور هون لكل المشاركين راح ابدا لقائي زي ما حكينا زي ما وصلت لي اخ عبد السلام في دعاء اليوم انا خلينا من المستمع من المستمعات
ام راو بتقدر تحكي بالعبراني خليها تترجمي كالربانيت
انا الدعاء بالعربي
Yeah, I can translate that Siham said greetings to all our present and that she would like to share with us today a prayer. Dua is a
prayer. Dua in Arabic. Dalia. Arabic.
She will first share it in Arabic because there are words there that cannot be translated to Hebrew.
אז רסן.
Yeah, תודה.
طيب.
תודה.
אול אישי תחיית לג'מיע המשרקות من جميع المدن ومن الضفة ولأول مرة أنا بشوف هذول الصبايا وهذا حلو إن نلتقي مع نساء جدد والأحسن والأهم إنه اليوم المتكلمات كلهم سيدات قياديات وهذا قسم من النجاح إلنا كنساء وهذا شرف كبير إلنا إنه المتكلمات إنهم نساء إلهم دور في المجتمع وإلهم تأثير فعبد السلام طلب مني مع إنه إحنا في وضع في الكورونا وضع كثير صعب مش بسيط اللي تشوقنا في هاي الفترة إلى كل اللقاءات وإلى أعمالنا وإلى إنجازات اللي إحنا نقوم فيها اللي الكورونا حدت من هذا العمل
أترجم
ترجم
Blessings to all of you here. Yes, blessings to all of you here all around the world and the people coming to be with us and to pray with us. It's so great to be with you and it's very special meeting and prayer meeting to me because the women will lead these prayers today. And I really so happy to see all of these women coming here, especially the Palestinian women, they came to be with us. And this is first time I see all of these women, the Palestinian women, and I hope in the future to see them face to face and to come to us and we'll go to them to create more meetings together. Yeah, totally.
هذول الصبايا اللي حكوا اليوم الاخت النابلس من جنين ذكروني في قبل 20 سنة أول ما بدينا قدي كنا هيك في تخوف وفي تلبك وننجح مننجحش. اليوم لازم يعرفوا إن إحنا اليوم سيطرنا على كل هاي اللقاءات، واليوم إلنا من تقريب 1000 امرأة من جميع الطوائف اللي إحنا بنجتمع مع بعض في كل المحلات. اليوم كلمة واحدة بكون حوالينا أكثر من حوالي 1000 مرة اللي بيشاركونا على مدار السنة، بتأمل إنه يوما ما توصلوا وتتركوا وراكم هذا الإيمان بس يآمنوا فيكم كنساء عن جد بتحبوا السلام، وإنكم حابين تعملوا إشي من أجل التقارب والمحبة بين الديانات. هذا اللي أنا سويته في دالية الكرمل اللي كان إلي سنين هون بحكيش مع امرأة مسلمة أو مع امرأة مسيحية، اليوم إحنا بيت واحد، وهذا بفضل جمعية السلام وفضل غسان والأحباب هون.
Okay, it reminds me 20 years ago when we began to work in Abrahamic Reunion and the fear that we had, big fear we had, will we succeed or no? The people will come to be together or no? But today I want to tell you, after 20 years work and meetings, today we have 1,000 women working on this field to bring all the people together. She said in the past I didn't speak with Muslim women or other women, but today I'm going to knock the doors to talk to the people and to the women and to bring them to be together. And I would like to thank Abrahamic Reunion and the people of Abrahamic Reunion. They brought us to be one family.
دعاء كتبته دعاء الشفاء، اللهم اشفنا من كل علة وهبنا الصحة وهبنا الصحة والمسرة.
اللهم sickness and give us health and happiness.
اللهم خفف علينا ثقل الأوجاع وابعد عنا كل الوباء.
God, make the weight of all of this painful so soft, and reject from us, throw from us all of these diseases. تفضلي.
اللهم بك نستعين وإليك الرجاء، إنك سميع مجيب للدعوات.
God, we need your protection. And please answer all of our prayers.
نتبارك بلطفك يا خير العالمين. آمين. آمين.
الله.
باختصار.
We blessed by your grace. Oh God. Amen. 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 شكرا يا سهام. أيتها القائدة العظيمة.
باختصار. أعطيكم العافية. أعطيكم العافية.
آمين. 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 شكرا سهام. تدا. Thank you.
Hello, Dalia. Hello.
Thank you. So good, Dalia, to be praying together with you again.
And what did you get like, Dalia?
No money alive, and we're on the same mountain. Now that the corona is over, we can
finally.
Thank you. And I'm honored and delighted to invite Sheikha Laila Muhammad Hashem Manasra. But first, I would introduce her through her short bio. Sheikha Laila is a bearer of high and deep spiritual knowledge. She is the daughter of the Grand Sheikh Muhammad Hashim al-Baghdadi and grew up immersed in the teachings with many who come to her now for teachings. She is the wife of Sheikh Ghassan Manasra. She has 2 daughters, 3 sons, and 2 granddaughters. Thank you, Sheikha Laila. Need to unmute.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. يفرحني أن أكون معكم في هذا اللقاء أيضا، وأن أتحد معكم في صلاة روحانية نقية من أجل إنسانية جمعاء ومن أجل السلام المعطى لنا من عند الله سبحانه وتعالى، لأن الله أراد لنا الخير والمحبة والمعرفة. اللهم يا رب العالمين، أنزل علينا الرحمة والسكينة، وعلمنا ما يجب علينا أن نعلمه، للحفاظ على هذه الأرض ومن فيها. واهدنا إلى الطريق القويم لكي نسير بخطى ثابتة نحو غد أفضل لنا ولأبنائنا. اللهم اجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه، وممن يبادرون بالصدق نحو الهدف الشريف لصالح الإنسانية. ولا تجعلنا من الذين يقولون ولا يفعلون، بل جعلنا جسر اتصال بين بني البشر، واجعلنا شفاء للقلوب والأبدان، واجعلنا شفاء للقلوب والأبدان، واجعلنا كماء الحب يتنزل على القلوب العطشة فيرويها بالقرب والمعرفة والمحبة. اللهم آمين آمين آمين.
آمين آمين آمين.
لا أنا بترجمها. It's my pleasure to be with you at this holy meeting and unite with you in a pure and spiritual prayer for all of the, humanity and for the peace we given by Allah, because Allah wanted for us the best and the knowledge. O Allah, the God of everything, bring mercy and serenity upon us and teach us what we should know for to protect the earth and everything on it, and guide us to the right path for to walk the straight way towards a great future for us and our children. O Allah, guide us to be from these people, listen to the saying, and they choose the best of it. And don't make us from these people, they say, and do nothing. God guide us to be a connection bridge and make us the healing for hearts and bodies, and make us like to love water designed on the thirsty hearts for to water them with connection, knowledge, peace, and love. Amen, amen, amen.
Amen.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Shukran, thank you. Thank you very much, Sheikha Laila.
Thank you much.
Babaji, would you like to say something? We finished, right, speakers?
When I heard Siham's words about 20 years of struggle and fear, and now we have this vast network, it really moved me. But I must say, in all the 20 years, it's this meeting that brought the most tears to my heart and to my eyes. I know that the future will be pure and will be as God wishes. And I know because the proof of it was today's meeting. All the women were speaking about giving birth in their families, but today something is being born, the next level of depth for the Abrahamic reunion. And I am deeply grateful and honored to be part of it. And I thank all of you deeply. Thank you.
Thank you, Shahabuddin. I would like to thank all the speakers today. They were very great speakers. They gave us the power. And they gave us the energy. And I would like to thank Dalia Shakham, Rabbi Dalia Shakham, for all of her great moderation, and Zizi, Khatib, all of us, we are so pleasure to have you with us and to be with us. As Shahabuddin say, we began a new path, a new step through our big path in our world. You see, all of the hearts came to be together, and we will be together. We will look at ourselves at your eyes. You look at yourselves at our eyes. It's our pleasure, and really, we will not say more things. We need you to be with us. We need your support to Abrahamic Reunion, all of you. And don't forget to put your emails and your details, and we will contact you, because soon we'll be with you. Lots of love and lots of blessings. Thank you.
Thank you.